Dire team ban.
I would hope.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Back, ladies and gentlemen, game number three, VP versus Secret. We are all squared up, breadstick to breadstick, 1-1 in this epic best of five. Thank you, Betway, for making this possible.
There it is.
Wisp.
Yeah, this is what you were thinking, Trent. The Monkey King gets banned, and then all of a sudden you give him the Io, which they don't lose with very often.
There's more. A first pick Venomancer.
It's going to be mid. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Let's go. They're going to go Io Tiny anyway. What's happening?
Well,
they were prepared.
Dire team ban.
Yeah.
Maybe don't give it to them.
If Spirit doesn't ban it here, I think it's safe to say they did not do their homework.
No, probably not. I mean, they played in game one. They saw how good it was.
Yeah,
don't let it through.
You're totally right, though, Trent. It's a good way to put it. Venno dissuades the tiny pick, but it's by no means a hard counter or anything. It just makes the laning stage a little bit more annoying. I think Centaur also a good hero against Wisp and anyone. Wisp, Tiny, fine. You know, you can get in if they relocate. You can sometimes save your friends.
This draft is so fast right now.
They let the Disruptor through, though.
Yeah. Are they getting ready to pick Sniper here or something? Maybe they're thinking about picking Sniper or something. Yeah, maybe.
10 seconds remaining.
It's so weird.
5 seconds remaining.
True. Yeah, I was saying the Sniper is still available. I don't know. I mean, either team could go for it theoretically, but damn, that's crazy. The Spectre ban. There are so many available. They're all available. Right. I'd be surprised if they didn't pick Disruptor, honestly. Talked about it a fair bit. Like, I could check, but I don't know. I don't know if they... Yeah.
Keeper of the Light.
Yeah, it's like I think a lot of the people do like the Gale Poison Sting build, and they don't go to wards till later, I think. Is what people have been doing.
Ten seconds remaining. Five seconds remaining.
Some European teams have been doing mid, actually.
Reserve time.
Night Stalker.
Whoa.
Wow.
Radiant team pick.
I like this, though.
Yeah, this is the counter as old as time. The Night Stalker, Keeper of the Light. Keeper of the Light, the genocide of the Night Stalker people by the Keeper of the Light.
Yep.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Tell me more. Okay.
Dire team pick.
Nightman versus Dayman. The classic epic written by Charlie Day.
As old as time itself.
Ursa, now number four for Virtus Pro. They needed somebody that could be beefy. This is not only just a counter Coddle, but, you know, Venno, Keeper of the Light 2 supports, very susceptible to the early rotations of the Night Stalker. If it's nighttime and he's on top of you, you're probably not having a great time.
No, I don't think so.
Reserve time.
Offlane?
Yeah.
Position 3?
Yeah. Okay.
Garbage. Or you're gonna get...
I think you get the experience quicker. You could have more of an impact in that first night. Okay. All right, well, I'll just go screw off then. That is a good point.
Yeah.
Maybe they're not Bristleback too. What about Bristleback safe lane? Is that something you can think of for Spirit? I mean, I don't know if it'll be
Bristleback safe lane.
I mean, listen, I'm just throwing ideas out there. I thought it wasn't that bad. Head of the aisle, that's what I'm saying.
I think he's just too counterable. Silver Edge shuts that hero down so hard.
I guess
it's
that's
ridiculous.
Fair.
Yeah, but it's still... Bristleback might be one of the most countered heroes by it. It's his namesake that you get rid of.
True.
Think about
five
that.
5 seconds. Lina. Radiant team back.
Well, that would make Bristleback much better.
He would be
that's
of,
for sure.
He'd be a little good. He'd be a very good hero.
He'd be relevant, but they go back for the Lina, so.
Ten seconds remaining. Dire team ban. Five seconds remaining.
Yeah. Oh, God. Oh, my God. So it's Nightstalker. This is weird.
No, I think it's safe lane Lina. Position
okay.
Four Nightstalker.
Yeah.
Tiny Wisp mid. Offlane Brood.
That sounds reasonable to me.
I think that's the best way to reason these lanes. Safe lane is not terrible. I mean, it's a little safer for, obviously. You can farm up. You'll get that first Bloodstone.
I mean, I guess it comes down to what Trent was saying. If they want to, like, depending on the lanes, how they're going to be set up, do they want to send the Lina mid? Do they want to send the IO Tiny mid?
But why Brood here, though? Like, why Brood in this particular game? It's like you guys said, it coddled pretty good against Brood in general. Yeah. Like, return.
They must know something. They must know something here.
I'm getting at it. It's not an obvious Brood game. Like, none of these heroes are like, oh, yeah, Broodmother, we're going to shit on the Ursa. Like, I don't know. Right. So, definitely a comfort pick, safe to say. Well, I thought it was because of blinding light, because it's AoE blind, so you blind all the baby spiders. True. I think you still buy it too, man.
Sven stands ready.
Well. They get, like, the Solar Crest or the Glimmer Capes, well, too, yeah.
Another hero that's great against Brood, Sven. More cleave, AoE stuns.
Wow, so... question, because every time I see this hero played in support, it's awful. It's awful when it's played in support.
But Chakra opens up possibilities.
Right, it does. I agree with you.
What fucks it up is his crap mana pool. So, I mean, yeah, there's some merit there.
5 seconds remaining.
It's so strange. It's so weird.
Well, welcome to the Betway Arena show match, ladies and gentlemen. Fifth pick Brood here in game number three.
Yeah. I feel like that last pick's Fen. I actually like Team Spirit's draft a lot. Like you were talking about, Fen, pretty fluid lanes in terms of where you're going to position Alina, the Tiny, and the IO. They can move around pretty easily, so.
I mean, I haven't.
Right, right.
That's true. Yeah. All right, well, we'll see what happens with this game. Personally, I've got some faith in Brood here, gang. I think even if, if they shut her down, she'll still create enough space that Lina is going to be able to split farm alongside the Tiny and do some more. Mm-hmm. But we'll see. Hopping into the game, we once again.
Well, thank you very much, panel. This is probably the craziest draft of all the games we played, and we have seen some very interesting picks. Brax, what do you make about this Broodmother last pick?
It's definitely a comfort pick. When I look at this game, I don't think this is the greatest Broodmother game in the world, but I'm not DK Phobos. This guy plays, he's played Broodmother forever, pretty much. We actually have support Centaur for VP, and it is the offlane Venomancer.
Is this level one Roach?
Alright.
Oh my, okay, they're going for it here, and they've got the damage.
Dirty strategy, too. They're chatting it up, you know, asking how's your day? Weather over here is
casual.
Great.
Yeah,
you?
They're just... Well, back and forth. Alright, Ursa's had enough. He's gonna de-aggro. He misses the aggro, though, and pops his salve. One of the salves wasted, though, so it's gonna be a little bit more difficult. Ben needs to hop out. This is, Spirit. They don't suspect a thing. They're just pacing back and forth, maybe a little curious why they haven't seen any rotations for wards, but Roche already below half health, and the hero's still at it, so... Level 1 Roche looks like it's going to be successful. Wow, okay. Yeah, game 3 is shaking it up, man.
Is this good enough?
I mean, starting with an Aegis versus Magic. Looks like it will go the way of Ursa. Alright, so he starts out with a poor man shield and an Aegis, buys up some boots. They're all chatting the happy faces because they're real happy that they got away with that, and oh my. If anyone speaks Russian, I'm sure this is way more entertaining. Mid lane, it looks like it's going to be our IO Tiny. Nothing shaking it up there. Off lane, Broodmother. Rather, long lane Broodmother, but she'll be by herself. Why is the abdomen so big on that Brood set?
I don't know, it looks really weird.
It's like too much spider butt. It's just offensively large. Alright, no one... Gonna be our mid Ursa here, starting out with the Aegis, so we can get a little bit more aggressive. Level 1 Tiny, pretty easy to smack down. And then down here, we're gonna have Pasha trying his best against a tri-lane as DK Phobos makes his way back down bottom, realizing top lane, plus save for our Lina, who is going to be our core. So, definitely some interesting lane swaps here. Mid lane, no one getting very, very low, but Centaur, our support buddy, just gonna be zoning everyone back.
Pretty nice to have the Aegis against the IO Tiny. That's pretty cool. You know, it's really hard for them.
Oh, wow, they're going in. They can score first blood here, and they will be able to do so. Nice setup there, and now it's just Vanscore left by his lonesome as Ursa is dominating this mid. That level 1 Roche was a bold play, but so far paying off.
It's going to be quite difficult for IO Tiny to snowball in the mid lane, especially when they can't even kill this Ursa.
Well, Sven down bottom facing a little bit of trouble there. Gonna get nibbled on by the spider as our support Night Stalker just keeps smacking away. I mean, how do you feel that these kind of quirky positions and swaps are gonna be having an effect on the game?
I think it would have been really good for Spirit, but they can't really pressure the mid lane. Like, IO Tiny are. They feel pretty powerless against this Ursa, even with the contact and power.
Oh! Yeah. Avalanche.
Like, they just comboed the Ursa and he took, like, super damage.
Bottom lane, though. They're going in. A nice Illuminate kills off the spider. Solo comes down, and he is aggressive there. Doesn't have a mana leak, because it's not usually typical to pick that up so early, so they can't go ahead and lock down the second hero, but Ramzes finds something for himself.
Yeah, they get that kill, even without Sven having stun. He's got 2 points in cleave, 1 in the Warcry.
I mean, picking Broodmother into a Keeper of the Light and also now a Sven to counter him, is that going to be too difficult for the Brood to do anything?
Yeah, you can already see how difficult it is for him to really do anything. Even when he builds up like a Spiderling army, it just won't do anything. You know, he can farm jungle with it. That's about it. Like, Sven is perfectly fine with just sitting in this lane farming. But once, the thing about Broodmother is when he starts to control the lane and gets a lot of spiders, then they'll look to rotate down to his lane and they'll fight with the spiders. And that's when he's really strong.
Oh, they got a sentry down as well. Sven's starting to go to town, and oh, just a couple more chops would have done the job, but you can already see how difficult it's going to be to lane with this Broodmother. His lane, no one. He's fresh out of mana, and his Aegis is going to be expiring somewhat soon, so he's gotta play this one right. Currently, just by his lonesome Venomancer, getting a lot out of the jungle right now.
Transitioning into that jungle Venomancer that we typically see. And Lil is playing the offlane now with his Centaur, so they found a way to kind of like salvage their picks into the Broodmother, right? They picked this Sven, when they probably originally intended for this Venno to be like a mid laner. And Ursa in the safe lane, but they're able to rotate their heroes around. They're nice and flexible. This mid lane is so scary for Team Spirit. Ursa's just running back and forth at him. He can't do anything.
Yeah, I mean, the only thing I can see going terribly wrong is if Ursa mistimes this Aegis and, you know, accidentally just blows it and then immediately dies. Like, that could be pretty difficult to deal with, but for now, DP definitely reading the lanes well, showing that they are flexible. Aegis now popped in the mid. Ursa gonna get tossed back up, but they do have the Nightstalker rotating in. This is what we talked about. As the Aegis goes down, this could be lethal. Tiny, he needs a little bit more mana. Wisp giving him the juice. Is it gonna be quick enough, though? They do have the Void. They trap him under the tower. A couple more hits, and it will be enough. The Ursa brought down off his pedestal with three heroes there in the mid lane.
Yep. Nice gank. Meanwhile, the Broodmother goes down in the offlane again.
She's having a real difficult time as, well, they've got the dust, they bring Venomancer forward. Is DK Phobos just gonna chain die in this offlane? And it looks like that's at least gonna be part of the problem.
Yeah.
I think at this point, a dust and Sven is all you need to take her out repeatedly.
Absolute disaster. This is not the game Broodmother can play.
What do you do with
it? On mid. Nice toss back on the Ursa here.
Oh, right into the Nightstalker's jaws, and he's gonna be walking through, but taking that tether slow, and he's in some trouble there. Keep where the light, though, gets a fantastic Illuminate. Pasha's in. I bet he wishes he had his level 6. No one is still alive, looking to make this a double. FNG goes down as well. Brax, did they just do that? What?
That's so sad.
Yeah, game two looked so good for Spirit. It looks like they finally hit their stride, but this draft may just be too quirky for Spirit to execute. I want to know what that alt chat says.
He's saying ha ha ha. 3x1 gets killed. Oh no.
I mean, they are really getting feisty here in game three.
Yep, all these players very familiar with each other. Sure, they've all played around with each other on different teams. This Broodmother may have been quite the blunder in the draft. Looks very hard to play around this game.
Yeah, I mean, you called it out as a comfort pick, and even if you've got the best execution in the world, just picking it against a Keeper of the Light is so difficult, and knowing that there's still a pick left to respond to it, Sven is the obvious choice, and I think they were trying to test BP's flexibility, but clearly they're making it work.
They were trying to, they know that, like, Brood isn't gonna have the best game, but it would open up the game for Io and Tiny, because it'd be really hard to keep defend their mid lane. But they did the level 1 Rosh, Ursa had Aegis, they even killed mid lane, and then now we saw a disastrous, you know, toss back. Ursa lives with 10 HP, and they killed two heroes there. Like, they've lost all momentum in their lanes, pretty much.
Brax, do you think this was a Rosh planned out right from the start? Do you think they went into game 3 thinking, alright, let's pick a level 1 Rosh draft, or did the cards just fall in place?
It all came together afterwards, you know. They're like, alright, let's spend, just try to go for it.
Oh, Pasha. Could be in some trouble there. Squirts out the Snot and VP. They're rotating for this. They bring in two heroes, and it looks like FNG is the one that gets to eat it. He is just way too far behind tower. Rude sprays out a web, but there's the blinding light. They bring Lina closer. They stun her up. There's an Illuminate. Gonna clip her right in the face, and that's more than enough damage to get another kill for no one. Man, this is getting real aggressive. They're gonna go ahead and scan this out, realizing that Broodmother still is in the area, but she's gonna very hastily retreat back to the jungle where she's safe.
And, what's funny about this is, Ursa's actually perfectly fine against him. He can level up the Earth Shock in lane, and it actually destroys Broodmother. And he would have perfect length to keep eating mana over and over. Then, like, Dyer's they actually can't touch under attack. You got the armor and cleave. Literally, just can't come in the room at all. Gets dust and stunned up and just dies.
Oh? Oh, they're probably gonna find a return kill here on the Keeper of the Light, but oh no, is this another bait? Oh man, they're going right back in, channeling up the Illuminate. There's a dust popped out too, so they got vision on the spider. There will be a Laguna Blade, and now Spence is in trouble. Ramsey's doing his best with the cleave. Ursa wrapping around, taking the long route for this one. Io's there, keeping the Lina nice and healthy. Ramsey's eats the Dragon Blade, doesn't want to get caught into the trees. Nice blinding light, but the toss forward onto the Io will secure a kill now. EZZ still up, and with the Dragon Slave finds another kill. So immediately turning this back around. Looks like VP may have been able to play that a little bit better, but underestimating Spirit a little bit.
Alright, nice turnaround there with the Broodmother's lane. This is when it gets scary, right? They die, and it's hard to like come back because, you know, once they take control of that area of the map, it's really difficult to carry to walk into that sort of area.
Dire's middle tower army and really is under attack. Tower now. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant structure.
Is this enough space to make the Broodmother pick worth it? It seems like it's so crippled early on, and yeah, you can take a tier 1 tower, but were there better offlaners to pick here?
This will definitely need to happen a couple more.
Is under attack.
Yeah. Make, Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Especially with that well into the game, especially against all this hate. Probably was something better. I don't know off the top of my head. Is under attack. Not that bad, honestly. Like, they do have control over this lane. Tiny does almost have a full stack of 200 gold away. There's so many stacks.
Oh, man, Broodmother. Really getting aggressive with this. Spiderling's Caudle going in. The Illuminates have done a good job raking in gold for him, and you can see him just... This Caudle's gonna be pretty rich if he just keeps sitting there and illuminating the wave of the spiders.
Dire's middle tower.
Ben still finding some good farm for himself. In terms of net worth, he's right up there with his Ursa. They are neck and neck, and Sven going in for that very early armlet. Already picking up the, basically everything he needs except for the blades.
Quiet the steam wheel off lane centaur. He's actually very, very close to blink dagger.
Man. He started the game helping out mid and then transitioned into that greedier role, and it's working out. He's gonna have his blink at a very good time. Now down bottom. Seems to be where the action's going down. DK Phobos still wants to keep up the pressure off the tower, but with Caudle now permanently here, it's very difficult.
The tower will fall now. They have relocate on this. Tiny showed his blink dagger man. Very scary. He's down here.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
He's been not playing like Dire's a traditional jungle farmer. Ooh,
he's gonna TP right on out of here. They are able to get him. Oh, Lightstrike Array into Laguna. That's a nice pick and will 100% secure this tower.
Radiant's bottom tower.
There's
is
a TP
attack.
In from Keeper of the Light. That is ambitious here. He's gonna get Lightstruck right as he moves in. But with Sven following up, it looks like they should be able to get the deny here, so. Radiant's nice play. Ramsey is forced to rotate and give up some free farm top, but in exchange for making sure that Spirit's goal doesn't get too out of control early on. Mid lane. Oh, he goes for the tether, just trying to juke and jab him around, but Ursa is a speedy boy. He'll be able to find that kill. Dragon Slave doesn't clip, so BZZ can't find any return on that. Meanwhile, in the jungle, just got Tiny and Nightstalker crawling around. It's gonna be dangerous for them. He's got Centaur ready to go. Stampede on cooldown. The catch-up's gonna be more difficult, but he does have his Blink Dagger ready at, you know, 11 minutes in the game, and Broodmother wanting to make sure she secures that bounty rune. And not gonna get punished for that.
Quite unfortunate. They had to use a relocate out mid earlier so they could go bottom lane when Keeper was deep. And then
Iceberg? Combo. Okay, he just blinks in. He's crazy. His mana leaked up. He's gonna be drained down. His Wisp is trying to do his best. He's gonna get healed up temporarily, but man, that was aggressive. Pasa doesn't have much left in the tank there. He's really low mana. He gets burned down by the Dragon Slave, and now very similar to game number one. It's just going to be very aggressive mid lane for most of it. Well, our cores are duking it out in the bottom.
Yeah, Iceberg, when he got his blink, he TP'd bottom to have a lane ward right on the tower. They saw his rotation. He ran mid, they had a ward up on the cliff, they saw him there too. Just unlucky, unable to really find dagger yet. But, you know, it's still early. He has plenty of opportunities. Relocate is coming up next.
Ooh, FNG, he's gonna be triangulated amongst all these heroes. Sven, very hungry for some spiderlings, so... Spectre Ray clips on him, but there's an Ursa ready to chase him down. Ursa's gonna go as well, and my goodness, there's a deep relocate, but I don't think they're gonna like that one. I think that was a little too greedy. Two heroes down, Wisp does not get to live another day, and the rest of the Radiant continue to chase forward. They get the mana leak off into BZZ, who's gonna be locked down. Double Edge secures the kill for Lil there, and it's just DK Phobos hiding out in the trees. Meanwhile, Pasha still continues to chase down FNG, trying to keep the slow up on him with the Plague Wards, but he will eventually find his way to freedom. Still, very good play there. Sven gets within an inch of death, but still up.
They had some vacation in that fight there. FNG spotted the call, was pinging him out. They relocated down.
Oh man, Iceberg all by himself. They know that Wisp isn't there, and they're gonna try to punish. Lina's TPing in, as well as the Night Stalker, but they'll get the kill before that all happens. And they continue to get aggressive here. Stomp not gonna find the TP as they're canceling it. BZZ though, still mana leaked and walking, taking a lot of damage. Illuminate clips him, so now Lina in a little bit of trouble, but Ben's core should be able to take care of that. You can just see VP rotating as such a tight squad.
Feels like
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Yeah, definitely a big network. Dire, they're spending a lot of their time in this bottom lane, really trying to put a lot on the Broodmother, just keep that pressure up. Ramsey's now gonna get scouted out by this ward, just gonna dip into the jungle, try to get some farm, and oh my! They bring exactly what they need to win this fight. The Ursa and the Centaur is all it takes, and now DK Phobos just once again scuttling around, looking for some spare bits of farm as Radiant continue to pile up the kills.
Like, who can IO Tiny go on have AoE Radiant's stun? Sven, Centaur, Blinding Light, Venomancer is really annoying. And not to mention, all these heroes are extremely tank side from Benno's gonna buy tank items as well. He'll get some health, Coddle eventually. I don't know if he'll go for Ags this game. Stalker. Players have a lot of different ideas about it. They value the 100% uptime on the farm. Blinding Light, incredibly annoying. And then some people value other items like Force Staff, Glimmer Cape, and Solar Crest to keep themselves alive in these fights.
Yep, that's just a really quick kill on Tiny as Vanskor kind of dipped off on his lonesome to get the rune, and I mean, VP just keep punishing small movements like that, and it's really starting to add up in terms of net worth. Already at 6,000 at 15 minutes in, and again, we've got two blinks online on the Radiant side, and they're not showing any signs of slowing down farm. Down bottom, we are going to have at least a bit of an initiation going forward as Ramses is trying to man up, but with four heroes here, it's difficult. Lightstrike Array clips on him, and Laguna helps finish the job. Broodmother finally gets some well-earned money off of that kill.
The Orchid pick, thank you, Zayori. Orchid very nice for pressuring whichever hero comes to defend the Broodmother. But it's not a team fight item, right? It's like just a push item that prevents heroes coming in one at a time to try to fend off Broodmother. Team Spirit don't have a lot going in for them. But they may not need it. The Broodmother still.
Sentry Ward dropped down there to kind of bait out the Broodmother a little bit, to drop the snot onto the spiderlings, and just keeping Broodmother on her toes. So it looks like with a temporary ceasefire in mid lane, Radiant are keen to push out bottom and make sure this tier 2 doesn't fall, because that could be perhaps enough of a window for Spirit to make a comeback. They get full control over Radiant jungle, it may be enough to starve out VP. DK Phobos now gonna get clipped, they got the dust! Oh man, this fighter doesn't stand a chance, she's missing left and right, and oh god, just blasted around, they're playing with their food! Nice pick pick there, and that's going to be a mega kill streak for our Ursa, currently 8-1-6. Had that one death really on mid lane as his Aegis expired, but since then he's been real unstoppable.
This is one of the worst things to happen when the lane is like Dyer's set up shop with your weapon and gets that push. Radiant's top feels like you can't go back.
Oh, Lina in some trouble there. Centaur forced back with that silence, but now Ursa with his blink wants to finish the job, and he is godlike. At 17 minutes in, they're going to rotate in the tiny whiff, try to get him down. This is a very high value kill. He doesn't have an Aegis, but there's the Centaur trying to slow things down, and Ursa still on the chase. He gets greedy and will feed away almost 800 gold straight to the Lina. She's now going to turn this around, try to go for another kill onto the Centaur. Dragonslave is enough. She gets the money from that too. That is a rich Lina. Iceberg is going to be able to deny the Night Stalker here, so making sure Venomancer doesn't pile up the money.
Nice place from King's Choice. They do have some ways to fight like that. The Dire's bottom tower is under attack. But, yeah, Broodmother just making her way down to the bottom lane again.
He's working
Ramsay's,
on it.
Build every game. He's got Armlet, Echo Saber, Blade Dagger, Blade Mail. Sven. Getting very strong, very close to Blink Dagger. He's going to be extremely hard to deal with when it's
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Roshan is pretty much available. Dire's structures are
fortified. Radiant's top tower is under attack. I mean, does Fear have a chance in hell at defending this Roche? There's a scan. They realize there's a smoke going on. They know the Roche pit is going to be on fire. What resources does that actually get in there, though? It's going down so quickly. Vanscore? Vanscore, you crazy! Alright, just come inside the pit, then drops out of stun. Alright. Yeah, he did find them, and he will pay with his life for getting that valuable information. So, Aegis gonna be up. No one scores a kill, getting that streak back online after sacrificing his godlike earlier on, and it's just looking really good. It seems like the later this goes, the better VP are in, and Spirit. They're just not scaling the way that they need to now. Here we go. This could be a really nice fight as they find a kill onto the Lina. Instant respawn, though. At least there's something to get the dust on the DK. Phobos is free pathing, though, making it a bit of an issue. He's going to be blinking away. This is a scared Broodmother build. Now picking up boots and a blink.
Yeah, just trying to be faces. Great space. Tiny can keep. Tiny's going for the aggro. Not a high damage item, but it's very good for farming. So, definitely going for the late game here.
Yeah, I mean, if this does go another 30 minutes on pace with this, say, like, all the killing stops, it's a ceasefire, can Tiny outscale this Ursa? He's doing so well, and Sven, we haven't really even seen an impact from him, but he's now got his blink online, too. He is a big dude.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Isn't that bad actually? Dire's structures are fortified. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Well, once it's like 5 seconds, you know, then it's really hard. Radiant's structures are fortified. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Yeah, they know Brood doesn't want to rotate back, and a Wisp can't do much on his own, so it's going to be FNG left to defend this, and he is just destroyed. Lil picks up the credit for that one, but this tier 3 is getting mighty low, and it looks like Spirit, they're going to just try to trade a tier 2 for this. They're not going to rotate back this decision. See if that's going to be a big mistake as Luna is now jumped on underneath the shrine, picked off. Lil moves forward, Craggy going to keep everyone back for now, but these racks are under some serious heat now. Finally, Wisp makes his way back in. EZZ respawning very quickly with that Lina, but wow, okay, no one is just fearless. Through a Wisp tether, EZZ picked off, and there's going to be the ultimate out from Venomancer. He does die, but he does enough damage to make this worthwhile. Ursa just raking in the money right there. Stormhammer comes out, and now Ursa's in some trouble. Lifted up, pops back, and his Aegis will pop BZZ back once again in this fight. This Night Stalker with a really dramatic death, and it's probably time for the Radiant to hustle out of here, as they got a tier 3 and a full set of racks, only sacrificing an Aegis and a Venom. Meanwhile, in the base, DK Phobos goes for a push of his own, does manage to take down the tier 3, but is going to be stunned up under Vision and will take the ultimate price.
Alright, That was probably the best trade team. Illusion. They really just can't fight. Broodmother, not the big fight. She needs to get into the back line and force it up to the bottom. Got to kill. So yeah, items coming up for everyone soon. Ursa almost has the Vexo, Sven's close to BK. Fight 6,000 gold. So, Lita came back in that fight many times. Just saying.
I think that was like 3 deaths and respawns.
Yeah, it was 3 deaths. And I was like, okay, you know, she decides she's losing some Bloodstone charges. Maybe she'll have a respawn timer now. Nope, 5 seconds.
You know, it's pretty fair and balanced. We are still pretty early on in the game. We're only 20 minutes in, so even her base respawn timer isn't too hefty. With the 30 seconds, that is. I feel like it's just a little too strong.
The respawn thing kind of goes both ways, right? If you're losing the game, kind of respawn, eat away some gold again. That happens a lot of the times. Heroes like Lion, you know, who get respawn talents really early on in the game. That are just kind of from the dying to get in there.
Solo living up to his name, all alone here, about to be caught out. Sven moves forward and Lucas gets silenced up. And, well, now no one is hungry, so he's hunted. Iceberg in some serious trouble. Light Specter not going to be working a GZZ. Now juking away on the back lines. FNG just running from the Venomancer. It's just everyone pick a target and square up. There's a TP out from the Night Stalker just extending his own life. But in the end, 3 heroes fall for Caudle. Sure, he'll take it. In terms of net worth, things hitting over the 10,000 mark now for VP. Big items coming out for their cores, and Team Spirit just feeling a little bit underwhelming. It's Tiny versus the world. Lina's got some good setup, she's got some good moves from the Luna Blade, but we've seen that she can just respawn and die because she's so squishy. And now 2 Bloodstone charges left. It's grim.
Looking tough for Team Spirit. Lina alive all the time, but she also dies in like 3 hits from it.
Oh, see if they've got any eyes on the spider. Realize he hopped out of the wave and okay, there we go. Fade time. Oh my, it's enough. Okay, they got some vision there. There's the center from the Keeper of the Light. He may trade away his life for this. No one's still on a wild goose chase for the Earth Spider and does find it now. He's going to be picking up some more. He is just untouchable with his ult. Sven moves in to follow up. Iceberg tosses him away, but it's just not enough. Ursa is back to godlike. 18, 2, and 9. They're not done here. They're still hungry. They're chasing down FNG under his own shrine. They got the Stormhammer. They got initiation for days. And it's an ultra kill for the Urza.
Whew.
I mean, Lina's up, but Lina can't do crap against this. The last time that, VP were able to go in and take structures. There was a trade. Broodmother hammering away on the tier 3 mid, but this time it's just going to be free for the Radiant. They're going in, and look how quickly these rats melt. Ursa's Desolator doing a lot of work here, and they opt to play safe and back off before they get the full set. They're going to leave the Ranger Axe. And I like this choice.
Yep, they realize the game is quite over yet. Throwing feet.
So they just back off. Roshan gonna be a shorter respawn here. Ooh, mid lane. Before the light, caught out on his own, and there's gonna be a big rotation in to pick him off, so. Alright, you got that position 5. Iceberg.
The
heart. He got 300 gold from that. That is a solid act of friendship.
Donation. Closing in on his BKB. BKB's nice, but he'll definitely need another item after that to really. Impactful inside, so he doesn't die to Ursa. Then instantly. Broodmother also kind of close to BKB.
Lina is getting aggressive here, misses her light strike array. Now Centaur is cut out by himself, pops into the Crimson, is not taking damage, and Lina dies again. As now Ursa's on the hunt. First hit bash, and then the all chat question mark. My goodness, how BM can you get? As well, they will kill off Night Stalker, so it is going to be a nothing for 3 exchange, and well, I'd say these range racks are as good as dead. GG called out, as we gotta spend just
Radiant victory.
pretty one-sided game. Broodmother did not work out, but if they can bring it back, they sure did the last game. The hope for sure.